Morning, Mr. Butler.
Oh,
I apologize for startling you. My name is Lucas Ward. I'm a new transfer student.
What is this?
It's every assignment I've missed so far this semester. Please let me know if anything's missing, but I believe it should all be accounted.
You really didn't have to do this, though.
Oh, I don't like to fall behind.
Lucas, you want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Thanks, Mr. Butler. Hi, class. My name is Lucas Ward, and English happens to be my favorite subject. I look forward to getting to know all of you through some engaging literary discussion. I just recently moved here from San Francisco, and I'm rather looking forward to...
Hey, Chris.
Outrunning karma, that boy, he's such a charmer. All the bugs and their larvae follow him out to Colorado. 10 dozen hearts in a bag,
their bodies lying, he'll drag
them down to Colorado. A modern desperado, and he'll race for miles through the night.
Lucas.
Well, in the introduction to the third edition, we learned that Dostoevsky was inspired by the true account of Pierre-François Lacenaire, a French poet turned murderer. As such, Raskolnikov, much like Lacenaire, feels himself above his fellow man and above the law in his brilliance, ultimately testing those boundaries through criminal violence.
Wow. Very good, Lucas. Yeah, see? That's very good, Lucas. Yes, okay. This is fun, right? All right. Everybody hear that? He considers himself...
Want to have lunch with me?
Yeah, I'd like that very much.
Bet you had a lot of friends at your old school.
I find that my time is better investing in one true friendship than 100 bad ones.
Kind of weird, huh?
So tell me a little bit about yourself, Lucas.
Well, I hear you're quite the scholar in every subject. Have you got any thoughts on what you want to focus on at college?
I know I want to go to Harvard. I figure I can decide what I want to study while I'm there because they have the very best of everything. And there's no use in doing anything unless you can be the very best at it. Checkmate. Chris, may I have a word? I just couldn't help but notice that you were speaking a lot during class, and I have to say, it was disrupting the learning environment.
Are you telling me to shut up?
Oh, I would never use such crude verbiage. But I would ask that you refrain from speaking while class is in session as a common courtesy to your lecturer and to your fellow classmates.
Look, Lucas, I talk when I want to talk. And if you got a problem with that, then maybe I should
I should jab my pen through your windpipe and staple your tongue to the roof of your mouth.
Hey, is everything okay, fellas?
Everything's great, Mr. Butler. Just wishing Chris good luck in the game tonight.
Oh, yeah. Hey, as we go into the weekend and you start digging through these next couple chapters, I want you to keep in mind what we talked about earlier, right? But then the very next scene, he's like giving his money away. He doesn't even have a lawyer. So, and I want you...
They sent me away to find them a fortune, a chest filled with diamonds and gold. The house was awake with shadows and monsters, the hallways they echoed and groaned. I sat alone in bed till the morning, I'm crying, they're coming for me. And I tried to hold these secrets.
You okay, Lucas?
B plus?
Your thesis that Iago was a heroic character, it's just a little off.
I feel that I adequately supported my argument with textual evidence.
Bring this monstrous bird to the world's light.
You say this is about Iago exposing Othello as a monster.
That's right.
No, it's not right.
Iago is the only honest character throughout the entirety of the play. It's everyone around him who doubts and questions themselves. They're weak. Iago is the only strong character who is true to himself. What is more heroic? But if you think that 0.7 is not that big of a difference, then just give me the A.
I'm sorry, Lucas. All grades are final. But I'm sure you'll do better in the next one. Bigger than my body, I'm colder than this home, I'm meaner than my demons, I'm bigger than these bones. You know the kids cried out, please stop, you're scaring me, I can't help this awful energy, goddamn right, you should be scared of me, who is in control?
Check.
I'm well acquainted with villains that live in my bed. They beg me to write them so they'll never die when I'm
check
dead.
Check me, control play, all around. You know what? First seed, Alex. Second seed, Lucas. Third seed, Sammy.
Excuse me, Mr. Butler. Did you just say I was second seed?
I did, buddy. You're doing great. You came up really fast. I'm proud
seated
of you.
Behind Alex, even though I just defeated him?
Lucas, you're new to the team, okay? Alex has more seniority. And second seed's no joke, especially against Glendon.
Right. I won't let you down, Mr. Butler.
Okay. Fourth seed, Justin. Fifth seed.
So let's partner up and let's get metal.
Bigger than my body. I'm colder than this
world. First up is Sonia.
I'm bigger than these bones. No, they can't cry.
Hey, sorry everyone. I was actually up all night finishing an application to be a college professor. Sending it off today, so wish me luck.
I didn't write this.
Oh, so you did not mail in this application. Doesn't look familiar.
Well, I mean, no, yes, I mailed that in, but someone must have done something to...
Who would do something?
Lucas. May I have a word? Have you been messing with me? I leave my laptop in here during free periods. The door's open.
Well, what it sounds like is anyone could have gotten in. Should really be more careful.
Yeah, but here's the thing. You want an A. That's what all this is about, a grade.
I don't know what all this is that you're referring to, but I assure you, so long as I maintain a perfect academic record on my college transcript, moving forward, I believe everyone will be jubilant.
What if I don't give you an A?
You know my biggest criticism of Crime and Punishment? The stakes are too low. Raskolnikov, he's a loner. He's got nothing to lose. But I always find a book that much more compelling when the character stands to lose everything. Do svidaniya.
Lucas is a kid. I don't understand how I'm getting bullied by a kid.
No, no, bullies, they hurt people to make themselves feel big. Lucas hurts people to get what he wants. Lucas is not a bully. Lucas is a psychopath.
Mark my words one day, you will pay, you will pay karma.
What if I don't give you an A?
Says, what's he then? It says I should play the villain. Mr. Butler, please. It's Joey's first day and you're already late. I will stab him. Sit down. Right there. Stop interrupting.
Touch him.
Oh. Shut up. Good. So class. Why do we think that Lucas took Mr. Butler's family? Huh? Anyone? It's an easy one. Well, how about some incentive?
I'm gonna give you an A.
Mr. Butler didn't give Lucas the grade that he so rightly deserved. So now, Mr. Butler deserves to lose.